H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
To understand Salesforce platform basics, let's jump into Salesforce org. So here, this application is visible named as Sales. So if you want to open any application in Salesforce, you just need to click on this app launcher. Here you can see various applications are available. You can click on view all. So all these applications are visible here. If you want to open any application, you can just click on a particular block and that application will be opened. So let's say I want to jump on service application. So I'm clicking on this. So service application will be opened. So here you can see different options are available like home, chatter, accounts, contacts, cases, reports, dashboard. Now again, if I want to jump to sales application, so simply I can search sales and I can select sales application. So Salesforce comes with some standard applications by default. Whenever you create developer edition instance, so all these applications will be provided by Salesforce. So these are ready-made applications that you can customize as per the requirement of your customer. Apart from these standard applications, later on, you can also create custom applications. Moving to these options, home, opportunities, leads, tasks, etc. These all are tabs. So tabs are basically created for objects. So in Salesforce, whatever data we store, those are stored in objects. To navigate around objects, we need to create tabs. So let's say we have opportunities. So this is opportunities tab. And here you can see some records are listed. If I click on this button and select all opportunities, so it is rendering all available opportunity records. So now we need to understand some terms. So opportunities is a tab which is associated with an object. This object contains various records. So this first row, which is having opportunity name, account name, amount, close date, stage, opportunity alias. So this complete row is known as record. Now, if I open this record, so here I can click on details to view available data. So here you can see various information are available like amount, expected revenue, close date, next step, stage, probability. So all these are known as fields. So basically, object is a collection of various fields. And if we provide information to those fields, so we create a record. So let's understand how we can create a record. So if you click on this new button, so here you can see blank fields are available. Amount, close date, next step, stage, opportunity name, account name. So all these fields we need to fill so that we can create a record. Now here you can see close date is having this asterisk in red color. Stage is having this asterisk in red color. opportunity name is also having this asterisk in red color. So it means these fields are mandatory. So let's say I'm providing opportunity name as opportunity test one. I am picking close date as 30th April, picking stage as prospecting, and I am hitting save. So here you can see opportunity test one, this record is created. And if I go to details, so close date is available, opportunity name is available, stage is available. So whatever values in particular fields you provided, those will reflect on the record. So this is one record. If I click on this tab again, so it will show me all recently viewed records list. If I want to see all opportunity records, so I can select this list view. And it is also providing some more list views. So as per the requirement, you can choose anyone. Now let's jump into another tab. So in this tab, you can see setup is opened. So setup is basically used to do some configuration in the backend. So this application is the front end of Salesforce. Setup is basically backend of Salesforce. So here various options are available, like home button is available where you can quickly find some things. Another thing is object manager. So while navigating around these tabs, I told you these tabs are associated with particular object. If you want to see what all objects are available in Salesforce, so you can click on this object manager. So I am clicking on object manager. So it is opened. Here you can see labels of objects are available, their API names are available, and their types are available. So in Salesforce, we have two types of objects. One is standard, another one is custom. So to uniquely identify each object, we have API names. So if I scroll down, so all these are standard objects. And in this org, I have one custom object that is named as college. And let's see its API name. It is having double underscore C appended. So this way you can distinguish which is standard object and which is custom object. Moving to home again. So here in quick find, if you want to do some configuration, so you can search anything. So for example, if I want to see company information for this org, so I can search for company information. It will be displayed at right hand side of this setup. So here you can view organization name, primary contact, address, fiscal year starts in, newsletter, admin newsletter. At right hand side, you can see other information like salesforce.com organization ID, organization edition, instance. So all the information related to org. So org is basically your company. So the related information are displayed here. If you want to deactivate your org, so you can click on this button. If you want to edit any information, so you can click on this button. So if I click on edit, so all company information will be available in edit mode. So I can modify these information. Next, if you want to search what all users available in your org, so you can search users. So available users will be displayed here. So right now I have four users created and it is showing whether they are active or not, their last login, their roles, their profiles, their usernames. So all information are available. So right now I am logged in with this user. So if I click on this, so the information will be displayed here. And if you want to edit the information, you can hit edit. So whatever information you are able to change, you can modify here and you can click on save. In Salesforce, we have profiles. So whenever we create a user, we need to associate a profile with a particular user record. So here you can see various profiles are listed. So one thing we need to notice here, that is user license. So we need to associate a particular profile with a license. Then if it is custom, then this checkbox will be available. If it is standard, then checkbox will be disabled. So standard profiles, you can just clone or edit. You cannot delete them. If you clone standard profiles, then custom profiles will be created and then you will be able to delete those profiles. So profiles basically manages who can see what with these profiles. Now, another option is view setup audit trails. So with this option, you can see last 6 months of change history in your org. So at the bottom, you can see you can download setup audit trail for last 6 months in form of .csv file. Next is login history. If you want to see login history of your org, so you can search for this option and you can see this information. So again, you can see 6 months of login history for your org. You can view date, time, user, IP address, and more login data. So all these are available in the header. These are some options. So you can choose these accordingly, whatever you want to view. And you can choose file type in which you want to download the data. So you can use this option for security tracking and adoption monitoring. So this is all about Salesforce Platform Basics.